Hi there everyone, this is Zach, and in this video, I'm going to show you a signature collection add-on I've created for Google Slides. First, I'll show you how it works, and then I'll show you how to set it up. Let's get started. We're looking at the form that students will fill out to submit their signatures. This works on mobile devices and tablets so that students can use their fingers if writing with the mouse or trackpad is too difficult. They need to type their name and add their digital signature. After they've filled out the form, they can click the Save button to send it. Once their signature is saved, it gets added to a Google slide with all of the other signatures that have been collected. On this slide, you can resize, rotate, and move the signatures, as well as add other graphic elements if you'd like. Once you're done, you can download the whole slide as an image. Go to File, Download, and choose PNG. This will give you a file with a transparent background. Now we'll look at how you can set up your own signature collector. First, make a copy of the template. There's a link in the description. If necessary, change the dimensions of the slide by going to File, Page Setup. The default size is 18 by 18 inches. The size you specify will be the size of the final image you download. Click Apply to save the changes. Next, you need to publish the link to the submission page. Open the script editor by going to the Tools menu and selecting Script Editor. This is the tool you use to write app script automations for Google Tools. The code for this add-on is already written, so you don't need to make any changes. However, you're welcome to look around or change it if you're comfortable. To publish the submission page, go to the Publish menu and choose Deploy as Web App. Set Project Version to New. You can leave the description box empty. Execute the app as should be set to the option that says Me with your email address. For who has access to this app, I recommend choosing anyone, even anonymous. While you have the option to restrict to just people within your own domain, this can cause confusion because apps script web apps don't allow users to switch between multiple signed-in accounts. Because of this, they may see an error message if they're signed in to any Google accounts besides the one issued by your organization. Click Update to save. You'll need to authorize the script to run. Click Review Permissions and choose your email address. The authorization gives permission for your copy of the code attached to the template to run. The data will only be transferred between the submission page and the Google Slides presentation. It will not be sent to me or any third parties. Scroll down and click Allow. The URL in this box is the link that you'll send to students so they can fill out the form. Copy the link, open a new browser tab, paste the link, and go to the page. Test to make sure the form works by typing a name, writing a signature, and clicking Submit. Go back to the Google slide that you copied, and the signature will appear. The add-on creates an extra menu labeled Signature Collector that gives you additional controls. Anyone with edit access to the slideshow will be able to see this menu and change its settings. If you don't see the menu a few seconds after opening the slideshow, refresh the page. Click on the Signature Collector menu and choose Settings. This will open a sidebar with different controls. You can change the text for the signature page to include additional instructions or explanations above the signature form that students fill out. The text for Thank You page controls what students see after they successfully submit their signatures. To stop collecting signatures, uncheck the Enable Signature Collection option. You can customize the text visitors see when signature collection is disabled in the Text for Closed Page section. Make sure to click Save Settings after making any changes. You can pull up a list of names that have been submitted by going to the Signature Collector menu and clicking Show Submitted Names. This will show the names of the people who have submitted their signatures in alphabetical order. I hope you find this tool helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments and I'll do my best to answer them. For more add-ons, tips, and tutorials, visit my website at zak.io. Thanks for watching.